New Year, new recipes. I need new ideas or new recipes because I'm cooking almost the same. And then when we go out to
eat, you want fish and salad?
Or veggies in the oven? Or salads?
Or salads are like, I don't get salads.
Or rice and beans or sopes.
Sopes are good. Sí. I know, yeah, but when are you going to cook those sopes?
Tomorrow, after school for lunch.
Tomorrow.
I'm very hungry and we are behind on lunchtime. I don't know why, but we like to be at home so much that before we know it, it's past lunchtime when we go out, no? When I cook, it's different. When I cook, I usually give him lunch around 12:30, more or less. So, like I said, I might get the pizza, he might get the Mongolian, but I'm gonna share, if you wanna visit Rancho Cucamonga, there is an open mall that is called Victoria Gardens, and I make a video about it. But we are going this time for the first time, which I did not share, to the food hall. So it is different, you know, like any other mall. It is like in any other mall, different types of small restaurants and a lot of varieties for you to choose for lunch or dinner or breakfast. So I will be showing you how nice this place is. Well, it took me a while to find a parking spot, even though that this place has different areas where you can park, and I never experienced a long wait in parking. But today, maybe because the holidays are over and tomorrow is back to school, I guess that many people chose what we chose to do, which is come here and eat lunch. So that's the name of the place that we are at, and we are about to enter in the food hall. Look how beautiful the roof. It's a great open door patio, and also they have different, for example, this one, if you are looking for a great sandwich, this is made fresh, and the prices, as you see, is very affordable. And this is one of the best places, according to Chris Burrows from Channel 5 News, the best one on cinnamon rolls. Sadly, he passed away on an overdose a few weeks ago. And he made a video here, he ate here, and he shared it on the news on his segment called Burros Bites. Okay, this is a Mexican restaurant. If you're looking for tacos, burritos, quesadillas, this is the place to eat. Now, this one is Tikka. This is Indian food. Not really my favorite because Indian food is too strong for me. So I will be choosing here later after my son. I will eat a slice of pizza. And they have different pastas, as you already saw, looks very delicious and fresh, and that's the pizza that I'm going to get after my son ordered his food. So if you like pasta, this is the place to eat, and also pizzas. Definitely this one is my niece's favorite. They have the best corn dogs, the best ones. I'm not overreacting, it's delicious. And they have these three types of different lemonades. So it's very delicious. They also have smoothies. And my son chose to eat here, so let me share about it. Food in Mongolia is affected by its extreme continental climate. Therefore, they don't have a lot of varieties on vegetables. And it's not very healthy to eat here, but let me tell you that it's delicious. So an exception is not gonna hurt. And also, Mongolian traditional diet consists of food that comes from the five domestic animals, which are cow, goat, sheep, horse, and camel. The cost of eating here is $11 a plate, and you can fill it up as much as you want to, so you can imagine that your kid is gonna be having a lot of fun. But let me tell you that most of these meals are often served with noodles. And I want to show you my favorite sauce here, which is the sriracha. So I'm going to get myself a little bit. And then I let you enjoy the, for me, very fantastic way of cooking. So see, these are the noodles that they serve the meal. Sorry for my English. I hope you understood. Here I have the ingredients that my son will need for this recipe. I chop onion, half of onion, I use the white one. Also 4 limes, 4 cloves of garlic, cilantro, and then he's going to use butter. And then I chose these tortillas for the tacos. We like this brand, and it's wheat tortillas. Okay, so what did you just do? I almost missed it.
Put olive oil on the pan.
We are going to season this meal with these 3 ingredients and garlic salt. Help him, even though that I had my hair all wet. I didn't want to be today recording a video, but it's fine. All around, just put like 4 spoons. It's just for the flavor, you don't need nothing. Just a few, because remember now, that's it. I forgot that you have to put the garlic now. We were having a little bit of argument, so I have to turn off the camera. Now we are more relaxed.
You don't see that
on
video.
No, we are more relaxed. That's fine. Butter, you can put as much as you want. Con la manito, agarras y pones alrededor, como cuando cocinas la carne, the same way. You lost memory, Alan.
Yeah.
You always cook me.
I have short-term memory loss.
¿Quieres más barra? Me gustaría si le pones un poquito más tono. ¿Eh? Quizás sea tanto. Sorry, qué aplauso. No, dale, que mira qué lindo que quedó. Mira, let me show. Let me show everyone how nicely you are cooking now. Perfect. Cayenne pepper. The thing with the tilapia is that it breaks very easily, so even if you try your best efforts, it's gonna break. But that's why it's great for tacos, no? I always have an after school lunch ready for him, but today it was an exception, you see? That's why it's almost 4 and he's about to eat just in a few more minutes. I didn't have the time, so I hate it when this happens, and he's upset only because he's hungry. As soon as he eats, he's gonna be fine, no? That's it?
Yeah.
You are just hungry. Well, this is ready, Alan. I think it's ready.
Yeah, it's almost ready.
So I got this for the tortillas.
Yeah, the fish is ready.
So here is to keep it warm. The after school lunch is ready, so I'm going to start showing you how to prepare the tacos. Onion. Well, now I am going to eat, and look, I'm going to put one of these jalapenos. Because they have oil and salt, and I'm on diet, I'm going to eat only one. One is okay. Okay, so now I'm going to share one taco with you. Oh, I forgot the lime. Let me put the lime. I am so proud of my syrup because it tastes like restaurant food, but with the good thing that it's homemade. I'm not just saying it, eh? It's delicious. I know very well the taste about tacos because I've been eating tacos ever since I was living in Mexico. And these tacos are making me thirsty, so this is a really great water, homemade. It tastes like cranberry juice. My son didn't want to be on video today. So, I understand, you know, he wasn't in the mood. So, that's why he's not here. But I'm gonna show you. Let me just have another bite and I'm gonna show you that, what he's doing. Thank you. Corazoncito.
Yep.
Everything is good now, right?
Yep.
Perfect. I love you, mi amor.
Me too.
Okay, so he's having now fun. I love it when he is at this time of the day, you know, playing with his friends and enjoying the rest of the day, you know, with school. Days go by super quick. So I like it when I see him relax, you know, done with homework, done with reading and eating a delicious homemade meal. And you know, I never make fish tacos, so this is the first time, and that's why I wanted to share it. I should have maybe not made a video because my son and me, we were not in the same page and not really in the good mood. You know, it happens once in a while that sometimes you just don't have a really good day. With my son, thank God, 99.9, we are always having good days, especially when we are together. For me, he's the son of my life, you know. Everything, anything can go wrong, but I see my son and it's like the sun comes out. So, but you know, some moments, some days I have my moments. I was very stressful today because, like I said, I got up very early to take my son to school and then I went for a walk. And then I had to pick up my sister to go to my father's house. I don't know if you saw, I made 2 videos from my father's house, and it's very hard for me going there because he lives, you know, in a house that is full of things that he doesn't need, like hoarding. I try to find the word in English and then I write it down. But you know, when you can, I don't know, everything was too dirty, everything was everywhere, you know, that's how he lives. And then cats were over there, like 25, 30 cats he has. And then on top of all, while my sister and me, he lives in Rialto. So I pick her up, we went together. So after that, so we continue cleaning, then we left, and then we felt better, you know, once we closed the door, just saying, hopefully, we won't have to come back there again. Hopefully, you know, because I can. Only if my father makes a change and cleans his house and makes a decent place to go, I will not come back. It makes me very sad and I don't want to feel sad. So, and then after that, we went to a super and then I got this fish, you know, that I just cooked, that I wanted to share the recipe with you. But after, and before that, I mean, right after going to a super, I went to Ross because I wanted to get a nice pan to cook the fish because the one that I had, I've been having it for years. So that's what I did. And then I went and picked up my son to school and then I came home and then I had the time to take a shower and take. And finally, let me see who is it. Who is it? Hello, how are you?
Good.
You wanna play with Alan? Alan? Okay. Three things. Now I lost track of what I was saying. What I was saying. Well, whatever. Now I lost track. So bottom line is just that I really wanted to share this recipe because I did make this fish before, but not as a taco. So if you wanted to make it, you know, your kids are gonna love it, you too, and it's a great meal to cook. So I hope you enjoy this video and don't forget to subscribe if you like it.